Let me tell you something. If you've never been in the snow, this is what I call a snowstorm. You don't want to try this at home, okay? No. Snow as far as the eye can see. This is a blizzard. And they say trucking's easy. Look at 3:15. Everybody already giving up. Everybody's giving up for the day. 3:15 Eastern time, 6:15 Eastern time, and I'm just getting started. Can't give up right now. Gonna keep it pushing until about midnight. All right, man. Take off once again. Got enough food on board to feed the army. Got enough water to sink the Titanic. So about to get off into it again. It's not nothing pretty, but want to make money in this industry. Got to do what you got to do. All right, starting to pick up a little bit more as we get closer to Chicago. So just got to take it easy. Stay at it though. Stay at it all the same. Just got to take it a little more easy. Well, I'm getting a little bit worse than what I thought. But, I mean, still, it's all the same. You know, stay at it, you know what I'm saying? And like I said, I'll say this before and I'll say it again and again. This is how the world is, man. Truck. Tight. Look at all the snow over there. Still snow. Look at where I am. I don't know where the heck. I don't know where this is at. Let me see. So right now, just taking a quick little break to get a shower in. Contrary to what people tell you, I'm a hard runner myself, all right? But a lot of guys get out here, they think you can run hard as a, you know, like a dog, and you don't have no time to take no shower. And this is proof. I'm running semi-hard and I always find time to get a shower in. All truck stops have a check it out. You got a sink, toilet, and a shower. So don't let nobody tell you that there's no showers out nowhere to get a shower out here. Wash your butt, please. All right, man, just got out the shower. Got myself freshened up. It's always important, man, get that shower in. And, it helps out with the trip. Helps out with the stress of being on the trip. Plus, man, I mean, you don't want to go around smelling like a dog. All right, man, back in the truck. Real quick point I want to go over real quick. Guess I missed. Hey, man, you want to keep a set of weights on your truck, you know? These are real simple, man. These are 15-pounders, you know what I'm saying? I do like a small variety of do curls. Then I do bench presses, butterflies, two back exercises, and do some jump lunges or jump squats. Real important to keep in shape while you're out here, because I'd say for 85-90% of the time you're pretty much sedentary, so you just want to get some kind of exercise in during the day. I do mine first thing in the morning. I do about two sets 40 reps each. Give me a nice, you know, nice little workout in. Keep the muscles tight. You know, keep the testosterone up. You know, I'm 50 myself, so got to keep that testosterone up. And, you know, good for bone health, digestive health. So, guys, keep that in mind. Just a real quick pointer. All right, man, so this is like the second day of the trip. So what I'm going to try to do is cover a major amount of miles today, being that I'm running exempt because of the coronavirus epidemic. The DOT gave us the option if we're hauling food product, and I do have food product, so they give us the option to run exempt, meaning we can run pretty much unlimited miles. So this is what I'm faced with today. Still snow activity going on. Don't know what it's like on the highway just yet. And here I'm trying to make it to Salt Lake City. I don't know if you see that. Got to do 1,135 miles today. So I'm going to try to turn about 11 miles today. Hopefully I can do the major part of that. It's about 950 miles. All right, guys. See you later on the other end. Just about out of Iowa. We're here in Nebraska right now. Well, no, just out of Iowa, getting ready to go into Nebraska. And guess the time, if you can't see it, I think it's like 4 o'clock maybe. So, 4 o'clock. 4 o'clock California, 6 o'clock. Nebraska or Iowa time. Yeah, taking a quick break. Took a quick little meal break. And yeah, if you don't know by now, man, it's always good to take, you know, nice quick little breaks. A lot of guys think they can get out here and run for 15, 20, 30 hours at a time. I've been at this pushing, coming up on 30 years, man, and I still, I'll run 3 hours at a time, take a break in between, you know, walk around, or maybe do one set with the weights, you know, keep myself kind of active that way, and maybe walk around and do some jump squats, but yeah, man, don't try to push it like that. You know, running 12 hours at a time, 9 hours, 8 hours. No, if you're going to run that hard, you know, get yourself a couple of breaks in between. Do it 3 hours at a time, pace yourself, and you'll find that your endurance will be a lot longer with the breaks in between.